Hey everyone, welcome to TechHalt. So today we'll be creating a zebra pattern in Adobe Illustrator. So we'll go to File menu, New. Take a new file, width is 1280, height is 720 pixels. You can take any size you want, but here I have taken 1280 by 720 pixels. Orientation I have set to landscape, and color mode is CMYK. Raster effects are set to 300. Click on OK. Now you'll see a new file is opened. Now we'll go to rectangle tool. Click on the rectangle tool and the width should be same as the artboard. And height, you can take any height. I have taken 20 pixels. Click on OK. Here you'll see a rectangle. And now I want this rectangle to be black in color. So I'll change the colors, I'll swap the colors, and stroke, I don't want the stroke, I'll set it to none. Now I'll take the selection tool, align, horizontal align center. I've selected align to artboard so that my object gets aligned to the artboard. So horizontally align center. And now I'll place this stripes properly because I want a few more stripes. So shift and up arrow key. Go to effect, distort and transform. From here you will select, turn on the preview, take any number of copies. For now I'll take 6 number of copies, and then we'll go to move section. Here we'll go to vertically move 60 pixels. Just check the spacing you want. If you find the spacing is more, you can decrease the spacing. So I'll decrease the spacing. So now I think it looks good. Yeah, now it looks good. Now I'll also increase the number of copies because I wanted to expand till the bottom so it covers our artboard. So click on OK. And now we'll go to object, envelope distort, make with mesh. You can select any number of rows and columns. Turn on the preview. So take any number of rows and columns you want. And here I have taken around 6 rows and 8 columns. Okay, let's make it 5. Click on OK. Now I have taken the direct selection tool and I have deselected everything. Now I will select one complete column so that all the nodes get selected in this column. Similarly, I will leave one column. Again, I will select another column by holding down shift key. So shift, click and drag each time. And now alternate columns are selected. Now I'll press shift up arrow key. Shift plus up arrow key. And so you will see the waves take shape. Now you have different nodes over here and you have control points, handles, so you can move those control points to the position you want to. So you can keep it wherever you want to. Simply click on the nodes, pull the handles, and then you'll get the desired result. So once you are happy with the settings, then you can stop. So once you finish, you can stop, and then we'll select this mesh and we'll increase the size of our object. We'll scale it up. Now again we'll go to rectangle tool, click and release, and this rectangle will be same size as your artboard. So again we'll enter the same width and height, and now we'll align center, horizontal align center, vertical align center, and then select both the objects by holding down shift key. Go to transparencies panel. And if you do not have transparencies panel showing, you can go to Windows transparency and click on make mask. Now as you see here, the mask is a bit transparent. So what you can do is, actually the color here is not completely white, it is gray shade. So we need complete white color to make it fully opaque. The levels of gray you add, the darker the color becomes, the more transparent it will be. So what we'll do is, we'll go and we'll change this gray color to white color. So we'll release this mask, click on the color, and we'll select white color, click on OK, and now we'll again click on make mask. So now you have your zebra pattern. If you have learned something from our channel, please consider subscribing to our channel and do not forget to like and share our videos. See you in the next video. Till next time, stay safe and stick around.